Hey guys, Izzy or Sick Izzy here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create a seamless gradient map when using more than two colors. This also ensures that you don't have any distorted shadows or midtones or whatnot. So let's get to it. Basically, what I did here is I selected some colors from my background, and these are just some colors taken from the image. And these are in no particular order, but I'm going to show you how you can actually put them in order. I created this tester here, and this tester is simply a black to white gradient map. So when activated, it actually shows which color is darker than which. And this is just to easily pinpoint the colors and organize them. So let's go ahead and organize these colors. Okay, I want the light colors on this side, so maybe this can go over here, since I know that's the darkest color. And okay, this one is lighter, so let's actually take all of these off. Sorry about that. And to make this one, all right, then maybe put this one over here. Sorry about that, guys. Maybe this one right here. You know what? Actually, I think this one might be darker than this. And you might run into these problems whenever you have as many colors as I do. Sorry about my English, guys. All right, so we have them organized now, and this is basically what we want, right? And let's go ahead and just move this over, make it look nice and. So okay, let's deactivate this tester. And like I said, this tester is simply a black to white gradient map. So, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna create our gradient map. And let's go ahead and create a gradient map right here. And now what we wanna do is get the bottom color. Our bottom color is gonna be this color right here. So let's just simply eyedrop that. Click OK. Let's add another color, and this one's going to be this one. Let's add another one. It's going to be this one. Add another one. This one will be this one, and finally, this one will be this one. And this is not really looking too great, so let's go ahead and fix up our colors here. So basically, we have five colors. If you notice, you'll have a location kind of input here where you can change. So we're gonna go ahead and change each one of these, and we're gonna actually try to make them a little bit better. So since we have five colors, and 100 divided by four spaces that we have is actually 25. So each color will be placed at an interval of 25%. So basically, this color here, the location will be 25. This color here, the location will be 50%. And this color will be 75%. And these other colors, well, you can leave them at 100% and 0%, being that they're the darkest and the lightest. All right, now it's still not looking very well, but it looks all right. Not really. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna head into these colors, and we're actually gonna change the we're actually gonna be using lab colors, and this is something awesome that came in Photoshop. If you guys haven't noticed, each one of these has their own color picker or color guide. I don't know what you really call them, but each one does a different thing. This has HSB, RGB, and LAB, and then CMYK. HSB stands for the hue, saturation, and brightness. Now, you might think that the brightness is what we're trying to look for here, but that's actually not what we want, because this is just simply unexposing the color or darkening it. It's not really, it's just, think of it like this. It's like adding a black layer on top of a solid color and simply lowering the opacity. So like I said, this is hue, saturation, and brightness, red, green, and blue. And finally, the lab colors. And these colors are luminance, red and green and blue and yellow, I think it is, yeah. So we're gonna go into the luminance. Now I've selected the bottom color and the luminance is currently at 14. I can go ahead and leave it at that, being that it's the darkest color. However, I am going to want to change it to around 10 because I just want a little bit darker. And you'll see that your new color is actually a little bit darker. So let's click OK on that. All right, now for the second color, notice the location is at 25%. So if we go into this color, the luminance, we're actually going to want to bring that down to around 25. That way, it actually matches up with our, with its location. So click OK. All right, now for this color, location is at 50. Let's change the luminance to 50. And finally, this color, location is at 75. Let's change the luminance to 75. And the last one, location is at 100%. You know what? The luminance is already at 95. Let's leave it at that. And click OK. Now, remember the tester that I created earlier? Well, this tester actually comes in handy whenever you're doing stuff like this, because it'll actually help you know that there's nothing wrong with your shadow. So if we turn on the tester, you'll see that we have a seamless gradient map. And yeah, it looks nice. So now that's actually how you create a seamless gradient map. So now how about let's create something freaky, something weird. So I have these colors here. Let's say you don't want to use the colors on your image. You want to use some random colors. And so I have these colors here. Let's turn on the tester and organize these colors. All right, this is the brightest. This is the second brightest. So it's actually, sorry about this, guys. So since this is the second brightest, I'll move this over here. Third brightest. And finally, darkest. All right, let's turn off the tester and create our gradient map. So we go up here and create a gradient map. Darkest color, we're gonna select this one. Oops, sorry about that, guys. And I'm gonna show you how to fix that. Actually, when you wanna color pick a color off of the on your image or whatever, you actually don't wanna have your layer mask selected. So just go ahead and select that, and problem fixed. It's a little trick. All right, let's do this one as this one. And since this is the darkest one, like I said, I'm gonna just turn down the luminance to 10%. Let's add another color. Since I know that there are actually three colors in here, I'm gonna actually change the location to 33% because there are three spaces. And change this color to this orange one right here. Change the luminance to 33% since its location is around there. And add another color, this one right here. Let's change the location on this to around, I mean, not the location, but the luminance to around 66. And location to around 66. And finally, the brightest color in here would be the yellow one. And let's bring up this luminance to around 95. So we have something like this. All right, now we have something that looks like this. And let's turn on our tester to see if it's actually correct. And sure enough, pretty seamless. All right, now here's something that I really like to do when using these colors. I'd like to change this to like difference, and gives you this really, really nice, cool effect. Obviously, the colors and shadows are now kind of distorted, but it looks really awesome. I don't know why. But that's pretty much it, guys. So I hope you learned something, and I hope you actually learn how to use gradient maps. And, you know, just go ahead and try them out. Go hop on Photoshop and just mess around. And, you know, you'll find something until you find something that you like. So thanks for watching, guys. And as always, like the video if you learned something new, and subscribe. All right, guys. Bye-bye.